appreciate it. When I was young, me and my mama had beef. 17 years old, kicked out on the streets. Though back at the time, I never thought I'd see a face. Ain't a woman alive that could take my mama's place.
Don't worry, just hold on. You can make it. Just hold on.
Hold on. Don't worry about pain.
Yesterday, a man said to me, when your world is tumbling down, but I said, here's my secret.
Part of the reason I want to be here, I have chills right now because my spirit is so filled and so full. I'm grateful because God did this for us. And what I know from when my mama, my grandmother, my great-grandmother used to teach me is if you're doing good, you ought to expect that the enemy is gonna attack you for that. So I think what we're trying to show today is how we react when the enemy attacks us.
Right.
We're not gonna stop what we're doing. We love our children. We believe that this center has just started to be and to find its place in this community. But there's so many other things that I know that God has for us to do. God provided this place. We didn't do it. No government, you understand? God wanted this to be here. He wanted this to happen. And he made it easy for it to happen. And that's how you know it's the divine order. When your path, when you're trying to do something and it looks, when you first, before you start, it looks like it's impossible. But you step off with one foot on faith and say, God, I think you got me. And you notice that every step you take, the obstacles just fall down. God puts all the people in place that you need to do what he knows needs to be done. So I don't have a lot of skill. I don't have a lot of anything. What I have is a willing heart. I have a willing heart and a strong desire. I sincerely believe in our young people. I believe that they can't be anything if we don't take responsibility for what's wrong. If we don't give them a safe place to be. This place is their safe place. And no one is gonna change that. So it was important for me to say that. I'm a little choked up inside, but I want y'all to make sure you stay here throughout all of this service. And in the end, we're gonna all have a real good time. We're gonna throw it all away. And we're going to rejoice and thank God.
I just want to tell you, give you a scripture. Psalm 92 said, it is a great thing to give thanks unto the Lord.
Amen.
And to sing unto the Most High God. Amen. So they will be singing, thank you, Lord. So we thank God for everything. We give him thanks because he deserved the honor. He deserved the praises. We thanking him for right now. Hallelujah. Come on, we praising him for right now. We thanking him for our uprising this morning. We thank him for being having the activities of our limbs. And we thank him for his goodness. And we thank him because in him we live, we move, and we have our being. And that is our honorful Jesus Christ. Praise God. So now our choir will sing, thank you, Lord.
The song goes like this. All I want to do is bless your name. Bless your name for all, for all.
Had been torn down, and he began to weep, and he began to pray, and he took and went back to the king and said, look, can you change this decree that I may go back and build this wall up? And the king gave him permission.
Do now,
Is also the anniversary of the 11-year anniversary of our cousin and my godbrother, Afeni Fuller. He died of gun violence. And we want to honor him today. And you guys have these envelopes, which is butterflies inside. And we're going to have a moment of silence and then release the butterflies, please.
Say, oh, girl, say, ow, looking at the cornrows up in the club. Girl, don't be bashful, girl, back it up. Before we start to turn it out, you must learn to crunk out. Before we start to turn it out, you must first begin to breathe.
I know they like to beat you down a lot. When you come around the block, brothers clown a lot. But please don't cry, dry your eyes, never let up. Forgive but don't forget, girl, keep your head.
You all appreciate it.